My name is Mike MacFerrin. I am a research glaciologist at the University of Colorado in Boulder. Primarily, my focus has been on the Greenland ice sheet and the way that surface melt has been expanding across Greenland and the effects that's having on global sea level rise. Years ago, I was backpacking across an island in southeast Alaska. It was a large island. There was a large mountain range that I needed to cross in order to get from one side of the island to the other. And in the middle of this range, I had to cross about a 3 mile wide ice field. It's a local ice cap with several glaciers feeding out from it. And it was a very foggy day. Clouds had come in, I couldn't see very far at all. But I knew the route I needed to take to get across this ice field. And about halfway across it, I became very disoriented and lost. I was seeing peaks in front of me that had made no sense on the map. I didn't see anything like it on the map. I couldn't recognize where I was on the map. And it finally hit me that these peaks didn't exist when the map was made, or they were buried under several hundred feet of ice at that time. And it really struck me hard just how large of features these were and how much this landscape had changed in that short period of time. I'm most concerned about the pace of climate change. We're just starting up this ramp. And all the evidence is showing us that the changes in the next 50 years will be more dramatic than the changes we saw in the past 50 years. It's difficult for ecosystems, for societies, for people to adjust to rapid changes in the climate. Small changes over time we can deal with, but when they start outpacing our resources and our ability to adapt, then that really causes a lot of problems. First time I actually went to the Greenland ice sheet. I went with the Danish crew up to the spot in the southwestern ice sheet. We took some measurements. I buried some instruments in the snow. And that was just before the most record-breaking melt season that Greenland's had in recorded history. There was massive flooding in Greenland. There was extraordinary runoff. The instruments I'd buried got completely melted out and destroyed. It was happening on such wide scales that it was such a wake-up call as to how drastic the situation was getting. What's really worrying to me is, by all predictions, that type of summer is going to be getting more common in Greenland. This won't be a rare occurrence, and it won't be very long before it isn't a rare occurrence anymore. It's big changes happening. It's happening faster there than it is nearly anywhere else on the planet. I wish I could just scream and let everybody know how big this is. Climate change is important to me because it affects so much of what I do and what I love. It affects not just glaciers and ice sheets, but it affects the ecosystems, it affects fire regimes, it affects water resources, and it affects everybody. It's a common misconception that small changes can't make a big difference. This idea that, well, this is such a huge thing and there's so many billions of people in the world, what is little individual decisions of mine going to matter? And the reality is that we got into this situation from countless small individual decisions, and it's entirely possible to get out of it that way. Recently, what's giving me hope is the economics of the situation. Our power sources, it's been long just assumed that fossil fuels are the cheapest power out there. And right now, for instance, solar is becoming competitive with those. The investments we've made in research into those energies are starting to pay off. As the price of solar continues to drop, I think we have an enormous opportunity to make large shifts in the way we consume power and the emissions we release into our atmosphere.